The city of Reims in northern France has been hosting something of a grudge match between two of the world's finest university football teams, France and Great Britain, two nations with an ancestral rivalry. And although peace has now reigned for 200 years, in the world of sport, there is still a keen desire to claim a victory. In the reception in the town hall, the atmosphere was a little strange because the last time they played was in the final of the Universiade when France got the gold.
I'd like to have a real shop window to better expose and promote university sports here. Vincent Grognard, our national director, suggested that following the French team's results at the Kazan Universiade last July, we could replay that final match here in Reims.
We have a great relationship with our French counterparts, and we're very pleased to be here at their invitation. I prefer to call it a rematch. It's not revenge for us. It was a very close game last summer.
So into battle once more they'll go in a so-called friendly. It's not a friendly match. We never play friendly matches, especially against England. It's a match we'll use to prepare for the next summer Universiade in Guangzhou. We have 10 new players in the group, and they understand the importance of this match well enough. In July last year, at the summer Universiade at Kazan in Russia, France found themselves in a difficult group with Peru, Canada, and Brazil. But they came through to play Great Britain in that final. We felt very good there. We managed to score the first goal quickly. We were very lucky as well, because our goalkeeper, Hugo Bacquet, managed to save a penalty. Then, just after the start of the second half, we scored again through an own goal.
We lost them. It did go to extra time, which I scored myself to the two goals.
In terms of possession, well, they had most of the ball, but we were very compact, and I think that's what allowed us to win the match.
It was a disappointment in the end, but the match was played in high spirits from both sides.
They lost the match because of our really great team spirit. It changed everything for us. It was massive. So now, in Reims, the teams are working on their strategies in private. The student athletes are missing classes this week, so they arrange their time as best they can to combine their passion for football with their studies.
I play on a Saturday, sort of professionally for Forfar Athletic. And that takes up a lot of time. There's two sessions a week as well, and play on a Saturday. But football is the sport for me. It's the one I chose, and it's the one I enjoy the most.
Football takes up a lot of time, but the studies do too. I try to do both. I just finished my exams to be a sports teacher, and I hope it's going to be okay.
I think the first thing is you make so many friends through playing sport. So the football group of people I played with, they were my best friends at universities.
The coaches are key figures in university sport. They care for the players in competitions, and they adapt the schedules to the demands of university work.
The soccer coach is very important because they have to understand your academic commitments as well as your football commitments, and it's a hard balance sometimes, especially when you're playing away on the weekend and then you have schedules and assignments in, but there's a great flexibility and the coaches are fantastic.
Wednesday, May the 28th, D-Day. With serious matters on the way, Great Britain are involved in last minute preparations.
It's difficult because we've got, I think, 8 players that played in that game and then about 8 new players. So it's difficult. We're just learning to play together, but I'm hoping we'll win. But I know France are a very good team, and first and foremost, I hope it's a good game, but we'd like to win.
The French team are on the road to the soccer stadium. Can they beat the British again as they did last year in the Universiade in Kazan? Tensions are rising, and a last word before the whistle.
I think they're very motivated about getting their revenge, and we want to rub it in again, so I hope luck is on our side.
At the Auguste Delon Stadium, France are at home. The support is for the Blues, but the British team are welcomed with respect. The first goal would come early in the first half. Jean-Pierre Morgan, number 10. 1-0 to France. In the second half, Great Britain pressing, and they score through Scott Wilson. The equaliser, one apiece, but not for long.
Here we go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over.
The corner comes in, and Pierre Mazur secures the victory for France. The final score, 2-1. And for the second time in a year, Great Britain taste defeat at the feet of the French.
Le double.
That is the double. And now we'll go on in the direction of South Korea because we have a chance of doing it a third time. French football in dreamland. Still to come on campus, cycling and the Swiss duo that scored a rare 1-2 at the university games. Gold and silver medalists Bernhard Oberholzer and Patrick Schelling.
When education meets sport and culture, what best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.